Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitya, a retired lecturer in metallurgy between Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm rendering exposition of the Gnostic Gospel of Philip, translated by Wesley W. Eisenberg, part 94. So, it is important one. Let's see. No one can know when the husband and the wife have intercourse with one another except the two of them. So here it is giving an analogy of the spiritual marriage with that of the secular. Indeed, marriage in the world, in the secular world, is a mystery for those who have taken a wife. So those who are married, they know the secrets of this marriage better than those who are bachelor. If there is a hidden quality to the marriage of defilement, how much more is the undefiled marriage a true mystery? Now he is saying the marriage, this defilement is the secular marriage. If you are married with a wife and you know how many divorces take place and all that, these are called defilement. So the woman can go for after another person and commit adultery. So if you know the how much you know hidden qualities are there in the secular marriage, how much more is the undefiled marriage a true mystery? Undefiled marriage is the one which takes place between soul and flesh. So and that one also could be defiled if the wife or the wisdom does not go by the what the man inside or the Christ inside say, but goes after some other person, as people are following Pope. They are not following, going by the Christ, which is the Son of God, which is inside you, but goes after another person, and then she becomes a prostitute. So our wisdom should do what our inner man, the Christ, tells her to do, and not that it follows another one for the sake of money or for the sake of cheap popularity and whatnot. It is the inner man, the Christ in you, because the physical body is the temple of God. The one sitting inside the temple of God is a Christ and not a Christian. Christians are people of the book who are dead. They don't understand what the solitary mean. Jesus came us to make us solitary. You become solitary when your wisdom is obeying the Christ, and in Christ we do the will of our Father, not the our will, our own will, or of any other person. So our marriage, which is a undefiled means that this is a spiritual marriage between soul and flesh, and it is a mystery. And this mystery we are going to reveal. It is not fleshly, that means it is not secular between male and female as you normally see it, and that would create children. But pure, pure means spiritual. So what is spiritual is pure, what is fleshly is not pure, is could be have exceptions. It belongs not to desire, but to the will. That means it's not according to the desire of the person that, oh, I want this girl as my wife, or that girl as my wife. But it is to the will of our Father. Will of our Father means that when you are born, then it is the will of our Father that soul comes from our Father God and join the flesh in the womb of the woman. And when that takes place, there are no more two but one person. And this marriage is pure, spiritual. And this is the will of our Father, that you are born in a certain family. It is not your choice. It is the will of our Father that your soul, which makes you living, and is the master of your house, or master of your physical body, was born in a certain family. So you should carry the identity of that family, and not take another identity, because you don't like that flesh. If you take another identity of the flesh, then the flesh become a bastard of your own free will. So, those who keep the identity of the flesh intact, they are called sons of man, because in Adam we have to establish our link with Adam. And in Adam we have Eve. If the person is a woman in flesh, then he has to be daughter of Eve. So this world is lived by Adam and Eve. Adam is the husband, Eve is the wife. And this comparison will be also given in spiritual language also. So what he is saying, that when you are born in a certain tribe or family, then it is not your own accord that you are born. If you wanted to be born in the family of the king, so that you can live lavishly. No, it is the God who gave you the birth, maybe in a pauper or could be a king. So whatever, wherever he gives the birth, you should accept it. So you should carry that identity, and to so that you are become accountable for your deeds. So the first will of our Father is that we should not conceal our tribal identity. And if you conceal it or change it, then you become a bastard of your own free will, because a bastard has no tribal identity. So this is called in biblical terms, it is called tares. Remember the parable of wheat and tares. The wheat plant are the sons of man, tares are the sons of Satan, which raise their ugly head only in this dark age, not in any other previous ages. So in Hinduism, when the priests were good and everybody had his tribal identity intact, nobody will conceal it, then the word Satan did not exist, or the sons of Satan did not exist. It only come into being during this dark age, when people start concealing their tribal identity. So this politics is a tribal affair, not of communist, conservative, labor, socialist, or Muslim, or Christian, or Jews, because they are not tribal selves. So those who take on these colors, they become unfaithful to their tribal father, and they suffer. So this parable of wheat and tare, the sons of man are those who have covenant with Abraham. And those who have break their covenant with Abraham, they are called tares. So these tares are bundled up in Israel, because both the Jews and the Hamas and Fatah have broken their covenant with Abraham. Abraham was neither a Jew, nor a Hamas, nor a Fatah, but a Semitic race, belonging to a Semite, or belonged to a Semitic race. So that's why you see them people fighting and killing each other in Middle East.